Hey everybody, Cartoon Fiend here, and I hope you guys had a great holiday season, got to see all your family and friends, got everything you wanted. And I'm really excited today, because today we're starting the two-part series that I've been wanting to do for an extremely long time, and now that the holidays have come and gone, I had a chance to do it. So this is part one of a two-part series on my top 20 favorite cartoons series of all time. They're not based on any polls or voted upon by anybody, just my personal top 20 that I liked throughout the years, and ones that had high nostalgic value, or that I connected with well, you know, through when I was a kid till now. And so let's get this thing started off right at number 20 with SWAT Cats. Now SWAT Cats is easily one of Hanna-Barbera's best cartoons they ever made. I mean, looking back on my childhood, this is one of my favorite cartoons. I can honestly remember multiple times when me and my friends were just sitting around watching a good episode of SWAT Cats, where they're fighting a monster or whatever. I mean, the theme song, oh, out of this world, so good. I mean, they had real guitarists on there, just wailing guitar. Easily one of the most memorable theme songs ever. It was one of the few that I tried to learn on my guitar, and I succeeded. I mean, it was such a good song, and the series was just great. You know, sometimes the lions were a little bit cheesy. You know, they always had the right weapon at the right time, but overall, looking back on my childhood, this is one of my favorites. So good, and I think a lot of people agree with me that it should have lasted more than two seasons, and it probably deserves some DVDs. So overall, great cartoon, cracking the top 20. At number 20, we have SWAT Cats and the Radical Squadron. Alright, coming in at number 19, we have Doug. Now, this is the only Nickelodeon cartoon I have on the countdown, and I think one of the reasons why the show was so popular is because kids that watched this, that were probably about Doug's age, they could really relate to some of the situations he got himself into. I mean, a lot of embarrassing situations, a lot of things that were just really weird or kind of funny. I mean, he's got your crush on your girl, you got the bully, your weird friend, all kinds of stuff. And it was just great. I think the only reason for me the show wasn't higher on the countdown is because ABC acquired it, and it just kind of went downhill. The settings changed, a lot of the characters changed, a lot of the voices changed, and they gave it a movie, and they tried to just make it more popular than it should have been. It was best on Nickelodeon. But again, cracks my top 20. At number 19, we have Doug. Alright, coming in at number 18, we've got DuckTales. Now, if you think back at your childhood and you just try to remember any kind of theme song, DuckTales is probably one of the first ones you remember because it's so catchy, it's so good, and I know right now you're singing along with it and you probably know the words to the entire thing because that's how good it was. But above and beyond the theme song, this is a pretty solid show. No, it's, you've got the uncle, the rich uncle, they can kind of go around and do whatever they want. He's got that giant money pit, you know, and that makes for a lot of interesting settings and a lot of cool places they go to. Because his uncle's so rich, they can pretty much go wherever they want, so sometimes they go all around the world, go back in time, go underwater, go to space, you know, all kinds of stuff. And it'd be above and beyond that, even. It set the stage for more duck-related shows to follow, like Darkwing Duck and Quack Pack, which had all the nephews in it. So overall, solid, solid show. One that I remember from my childhood, I'm sure you guys do. So that's why it's coming at number 18, we've got DuckTales. Alright, coming in at number 17, we've got Disney's Tailspin. This is another one of those shows that's got a really awesome theme song. Gets you pumped up for the show, one that everybody really remembers. And, you know, the show was just really great. It was one of those that was one of the few shows that had a good spin-off from a movie. A lot of times when you get a spin-off from a movie, it just doesn't work out well. A lot of the story's taken up in the movie, or there's just not a lot to work with. But with Tailspin, they did a little bit something different with it. You know, it was just about the animals, but in this, they gave them clothes. They, you know, made able to walk around, fly planes. So it just was a good setting for lots of action, a lot of cool stuff that, you know, kids like to watch. It was a tropical setting, so who doesn't like tropical settings? And I don't want to go into too much detail because I've already done a review on the show. And if you haven't seen it already because you're one of my new subscribers, please check it out now. I've got a link to it. But overall, solid, solid cartoon. If it ever comes out with DVDs, I'll definitely be one of the first ones to buy it. And if there's one out already, please let me know. So that's why at number 17, we've got Tailspin. Alright, coming in at number 16, we've got Hanna-Barbera's Johnny Quest. This is one of the more serious action cartoons on the list, and one of the originals on Toonami. Just one that I remember watching a lot as a kid. It was one of those cool shows to watch. You know, it was one of the better remakes of any cartoon series, in my opinion. A lot of them failed, but this one was good. Brought back a really solid theme song, a lot better than the original. Every time I hear it, I just get chills. It was one of the first series to ever implement a 2D animation and 3D animation. Now, again, it's one of those series I don't want to go into a whole lot of detail because I've done a review on it. And if you haven't seen my review, just click the link. But,
one I would definitely recommend you guys to watch. And it's got a movie coming out in 2010, so something that can last that long and have a live-action movie, pretty solid. That's why it's number 16, Johnny Quest.